then another story about leadership and system thinking. This is a Danish F-16 which crash landed in Afghanistan. And they were sort of in the same situations as I was. They were unable to get fuel, the weather was bad, and they got onto the tanker also. But they emptied the tanker before they could land anywhere, and the tanker left them, and they were using up all their fuel and had only one option to land on a runway which was not really suited for F-16s. And what happened was that the lead aircraft landed a little bit too long on the runway, and he basically ran off the runway and into a minefield where he ejected. So those yellow small posters you can see in the ground there, that is mines. Fortunately, actually a US soldier came and picked him up and brought him out of this minefield, but nobody got hurt from it. So when something like this happens, you go nuts in investigating why in the Air Force. So, you do a lot of analysis and you end up with a category, basically, of why this happened. And the category here was pilot mistake. And it's true, he landed too long. There was another incident that week. This was the first month, actually, of my tour in Afghanistan. And a couple of days before, there was a Norwegian F-16. He is landing home at the base, and he's slamming the aircraft so hard in the runway that the gear is breaking and basically being pushed up into the tanks that you can see under the wings. And they start leaking fuel as he's just screaming down the runway with sparks and stuff. And fortunately, it didn't catch any fires, but nobody got hurt. The aircraft got hurt, of course. But again, this was a pilot mistake. He just landed too hard. Maybe he was tired, who knows. A couple of days prior to that, there was a pilot in Afghanistan flying around, and his air condition broke. And you might think, okay, an air condition, how bad can that be? But it's pretty bad when it's minus 56 degrees centigrade outside, right? Then you get really, really cold. And what he decided to do was fly for an hour back to the base. And it turned out that was a pretty bad decision. Maybe he should have landed. He survived, but he was so cold that he couldn't get out of the aircraft himself. So after these three things happened, the commander at the base called us all together. And he briefed us on the situation. We have had these incidents, and they are all categorized as pilot mistakes. And he said, I agree with it. This is poor judgment. But we need to understand that every one of us being in these situations would have made the same bad calls. And it's now our task to look at the system, look at the way we operate, look at the way we do stuff so that we get ourselves in situations where we are making bad judgment calls. It's not those pilots who did the mistakes. It could happen to all of us. And we thought about it and talked about it, and what we found out was that actually many one of us had incidents in the last part of these sorties where we were making bad judgment calls or similar. So we came back to him and said, we think we are getting tired. We haven't really felt it that much, but we can see we're making bad judgment at the end of the sorties. And we took 6-hour sorties and cut them down to 3-hour sorties. And after that, we didn't have any incidents. So this is the kind of thinking that we want our super scrum master, the release train engineer, to apply. It should be the one who takes care of the whole group, look at the systemic impediments, the systemic things that make us make bad, not cooperate together, or get into dangerous situations. What Deming would have said, the lean father, Safe is also really into lean, is that people are already doing their best. It's the if you have problems, it's the systemic problems. So it's really living up to that idea. Okay, so this was a lot of ideas about SAFe, not a lot of practices and tools, but sort of the feeling of what we want to do with the Scale Agile framework. And I just want to mention the talk I have tomorrow about a more concrete example of how we actually use this framework to create this sort of environment. So if you're interested in that, please join me. This is also just my bonus for you guys, sort of my tricks for thinking about working together. So use that OODA loop, synchronize your mental models, create flexibility in execution, and lead with mission and local initiative and mutual trust. Please remember to...